Hello friends, welcome back to channel NEET, and we are going to start with the video number 20. And today's topic that we are going to discuss is about the viruses. Okay, so we are going to see up the topic about viruses. Now there are few steps through which I am going to discuss this particular topic. Okay, the first I'll be speaking about the introduction. The next I am going to speak for coronavirus. The third I am going to speak for types of coronavirus. The fourth, I am going to speak for the classification. Of coronavirus. And we will see the diagram of coronavirus. Next, we are going to see morphology of coronavirus, and next we are going to see genome. So in the following step we are going to see the details of the viruses. So we'll start up with the introduction. Of viruses. Viruses have a special property. Special property. What is that special property? We'll discuss. Suppose if they are in and surrounding medium or surroundings, a common surroundings, maybe a door, okay, or a board. Okay, on the non-living surfaces, they will be acting on the non-living surfaces. There will be acting as non-living organism. So this is the first property. If they are in the surrounding such as door and board, they will be acting as non-living. But if they are present in a living cell, okay, so they will be acting as living organism. So this is a special property what the viruses shows us. Okay, inside the body it is active and living, outside the body it behaves as it is non-living. Fine. So I told you that it has a special property. Okay, inside the body it will be acting as a living organism, outside the body it will be behaving as a non-living organism. Now we'll see up the topic on coronavirus. Now let's discuss about coronavirus. Fine. Coronavirus are group of viruses that cause disease to birds and mammals this becomes the point number one. Corona means crown like. The king has a crown, it appears that particular way. It will be circular in structure and it will be appearing something like this. Okay, so it is going to appear like a crown like appearance. So corona means the crown like structure. Now if you can see, it causes a disease in birds and mammal. Okay, this particular group of viruses are specially causes the disease in birds and mammal. Now we'll see the types of corona viruses. So let's start with corona virus types. So few are known currently. Okay, the first type is SARS, COV. SARS represents severe acute respiratory syndrome, and COV is a short form for corona virus. Fine. So this was the first time when we could see of the effect of corona virus. The next is MERS-CoV. It stands for Middle East Respiratory Syndrome. The third, what we found out is COVID. Its full form is corona virus disease 19. It is also named as SARS-CoV-2. We'll see up. SARS-CoV is the first one, severe acute respiratory syndrome. Okay, MERS-CoV is the second type of coronavirus. Okay, and third is COVID-19, that is coronavirus disease 19. Okay, which is also known as SARS-CoV-2. Fine. Now remember this, all of these three viruses have been originated in China. They have originated in China. So there is a major reason why it has been originated only in China. We'll cover why China is the only source of all these three viruses in the next video. Now we'll see up the topic that is known as classification of coronavirus. So let's start with the next topic that is known as classification of coronavirus. We'll start with kingdom. We'll move on to phylum, order, family, subfamily, and then genus. So the first kingdom is viruses, so it is belonging to virus. Phylum is Inserta, Sedis. Order becomes Nidovirales. Y rails. family corona viridae. Subfamily becomes ortho corona virinae. Genus is alpha COV beta COV, this is coronavirus, delta COV. Now let us understand what does this mean. Okay, virus kingdom coronavirus is been classified under kingdom viruses, phylum Incerticetes, which means that it is caused due to unknown source. Unknown source, or there is no clarity about the causative source. Okay, nidovirales means it is specific only to human and animals as host. So therefore it is nidovirales. Corona viridae, I already told you, it is a crown like structure, okay, which has a positive envelope and single standard RNA. So positive envelope and then single standard RNA, okay, fine. And these are finally their names, alpha, beta and delta. Fine. So indirectly we are going to speak with respect to the corona virus. So I'll quickly revise. Kingdom corona is a virus, therefore it is classified under kingdom virus, phylum Incerticetes, which means unknown source. Order nidovirales, it is specific to humans and humans host only. Corona viridae, which will be having a positive envelope and it will be having single standard RNA. Fine. Subfamily ortho corona virinae, and the genus is alpha coronavirus, beta coronavirus and delta coronavirus. Now we'll be speaking with respect to diagram of coronavirus. So let's start with the coronavirus diagram. Okay, it is a circular diagram which has two layers. Okay, it has some protein which has been embedded in this particular form with some foot like structure. So you can see some foot like structure which are present. In this particular virus, so I'm continuing to draw the same. So let's complete it. The pattern appears like this. So now you have arrangement of one more type of a structure. So you can see the arrangement on the surface. Then you have one special kind of structure on the surface again. then you have again an U-shaped structure, and you can see some arrangement like this. So you have an arrangement which will be like this. You have one more structure. Again you have an U-shaped structure representing on it and on the surface. After that you again have an this red color rounded structure, and so on will be continued. Now you have inside it, you have some structure which will be appearing like this. On it you have some circular structure . Now you can see this first and this as second. Okay, so these are two. I'll number it as one, I'll number it as two. Okay, so these are the two layers. I call this as lipid bilayer. Bilayer. This is an envelope. Envelope of the virus. Since it is made up of lipid, it is really difficult to break. So this becomes our structure number A in this particular diagram. If you can see this particular diagram, we call this as B, we call it as S protein. Or structural protein. So this becomes structural protein. The third, which is C, becomes heme agglutinin . So this becomes heme agglutinin . Next becomes M protein . So this is an M protein. E becomes E protein, and E protein is this particular molecule. So if you can observe the diagram of coronavirus, it is a complex diagram. It is not an easy diagram. Okay. Now there are two important components which we have to see. This becomes single stranded RNA. Single stranded, STRANDED, standard RNA. So this becomes RF naming. This particular structure, the blue one, we call it as G. The naming is nucleocapsid. So this is the whole complex diagram of coronavirus. Will quickly revise the name. Okay, as you can see here, two green layers, okay, two lines, we call it as lipid bilayer. So it becomes difficult to break these layers. In this lipid bilayer, there are some structural proteins are known as S proteins. So also in the lipid bilayer, there is an hemagglutinin. This again is very, very, very important. There is an M protein, there is an E protein. There inside the structure, there is single standard RNA. And finally, you have a nucleocapsid. Okay. Now, if you can see the arrangement, it is very specific and very different from other viruses. Okay. You have two M proteins. After that, you have heme agglutinin. Again, you have two M proteins. Then you have E protein. Again, you have two M protein. Then agglutinin. Again, you will be having two proteins, and again, you will be having an E protein. So this is the complexity of this virus. Okay. The other thing we cannot easily destroy virus is that the first is the presence of lipid bilayer, which is difficult to break. Again, there is a nucleocapsid, which means again the layer. Okay. I have not drawn it the whole covering, just to make you understand. Okay. So this nucleocapsid, again, it act as a second layer. So this becomes the first layer, both of these, and this is the second layer. To break down these two layers, it becomes very difficult. Okay, fine. So this is an arrangement of the proteins and the layers along with the naming of the coronavirus. Now we will see up the morphology of coronavirus. Let's start with the morphology of coronavirus. The first point that we need to discuss is pleomorphic. What is pleomorphic? It can change its morphology. It can change its morphology. Morphology is the outer structure. Okay, the appearance of outer structure, or it can alter its outer structure. Next, what could be the diameter? The diameter of coronavirus is near about 120 nanometer. That means 120 into 10 raised to minus 9 meter. Third, we'll speak about viral envelope. You have already seen the names. Okay, so I'll just quickly write the names. First is S protein. Okay, next is M protein. Next is HE protein. You have N protein. Let us see what these proteins can do. We'll just quickly see where the proteins are located. The first is S protein. Okay, then is the M protein, so that is N protein. Then there is mentioned as HE protein. HE protein is this heme A glutein is HE protein. And finally N protein. N protein is this N protein. Now, what is the function of that spike like structure? It will be helping for attachment to a cell. What does the M protein is going to do? It is going to help in the assembly of virons. Assembly of virons means it will be accumulating the virons. What will the HE protein do? This has a full form as hemagglutinin, glutinin esterase. So at the last it has an ASE, so it becomes an enzyme. What it is going to do? This is going to stick RBC or cluster RBC 1-to-1. Okay, so they are going to cluster RBC 1-to-1. They will be accumulating RBC cells inside the body. And proteins are over single stranded RNA. Single stranded RNA are positive charge and it appears as beads on string. Okay, this is what we should understand with respect to the morphology of coronavirus. Okay, so I'll quickly revise the whole. Okay, so morphology, we have seen the first word, that is known as pleomorphic. What is pleomorphic? It has an potential to alter its morphology, therefore the word pleomorphic. Its diameter will be 120 nanometers. Okay, I have converted to meters. Okay, then viral envelope, as you already know, these are two lipid bilayer. You have a presence of structural proteins, you have a presence of heme agglutinin esterase enzyme, and this is what is known as heme agglutinin. Then you have a presence of M enzyme, which will be helping in the viron assembly. Heme agglutinin, that is HE protein, is going to help in RBC cluster. Okay, and finally you have N protein, which is attached to, this is becomes your N protein, which is attached to the beads and string arrangement, which is attached to the positively charged single stranded structure. Now we'll look up the last topic, that is known as genome. So let's start with the topic that is known as the genome, that is the final topic for today. Okay, the first topic is that you have a presence of positive single stranded RNA genome. Okay, fine. So coronavirus is having positive single stranded RNA inside. It means this red color structure, what we can see over here inside this, this is single stranded RNA. Okay, and it is positively charged. Next is genome size is near about 27 34 KB. KB is kilo base. The genome size is one of the largest among RNA genome, means the size of this genome is quite big in the RNA genome. Okay, so this was some point with respect to genome of coronavirus. Okay, it is a positively charged strand, single stranded. Okay, it is not been mixed up. Okay, it is a single stranded structure, don't get confused. Secondly, genome size is 27 kilobase to 34 kilobase, and the genome size is one of the largest in the RNA genome. Okay, so we have covered the 7 points in today's lecture. Okay, the next lecture will be on mechanism of action of coronavirus. Hope you like today's video. Have a nice day.